Hey, hello friends, welcome back to video. Happy 72nd Independence Day to my fellow Indians. What's up guys, what's going on? I'm Amoga B. If you are visiting this channel for the first time, do press the subscribe button and the bell button in order to get the regular updates. This channel provides the information about C languages and tricky questions about C languages, programming for the device Cortex M3 in both assembly and in C languages, basics of machine learning with an introduction to deep learning. Last but not least, we are going to define some of the basic science and technology. If you are interested with these kinds of stuff, please do press the subscription as subscription is free. The last video, we have been seeing the difference between a normal algorithm working and a machine learning algorithm working. So the agenda of this video is to understand what is underfitting and what is overfitting in a machine learning. First and foremost, how to determine whether this underfitting or overfitting has been occurred in your training phase of your machine learning. This is primary. If you are knowing the problem, you can find the solution. So what is the problem is, if the training accuracy rate and the testing accuracy rate is having too much of difference. Consider if the training accuracy rate is giving 90% and the testing accuracy is giving 40%. So during this difference, there is an underfitting or an overfitting in your training phases. In order to explain an underfitting and an overfitting, we are going to consider a non-linear data set. Here, non-linear means data is going to be get spreaded all over the space. As I told you, this is a data set of non-linear. So this red color is going to resemblance for class 1. Green color with other shape is going to resemblance the features of a class 2. You can just observe the data of class 1 and class 2 have been distributed all over the spaces. So in order to make a difference between two classes, we need a differential line to make a decision between whether your test image is belonging to class 1 or a class 2. This bifurcation line is having lesser complexity, then we are going to call it as an underfitting in your machine learning. Technical meaning of this is, it is going to provide a lesser accuracy for your test results. You can just see here, the red color is going to be get classified, misclassified to an class 2, and the green color is going to be misclassified to an class 1. This condition is called as an underfitting. Then what is overfitting? Consider the same data set, a non-linear data set as shown in this figure. This is the same data set which have been taken to in order to explain the underfitting. So this is the scenario to explain the overfitting. You can just see this bifurcation line with a purple color. It is very complex in nature. Can you observe here? It has been having too much curvings in order to fit all of your data sets. So due to this complexity, it has been fitted almost all the training data set. It is giving a 100% accuracy for training data. If you are applying the same bifurcation line to an testing data set, it is going to definitely provide an accuracy of 60 to 70%. Line allows to fit all the training set into an class A and class B. This condition is called as an overfitting, which will give 100% accuracy only for training data set. For testing data set, 50 to 60% accuracy. Solution for an overfitting. So this is a very much simpler. Just decrease the complexity of this line. You can just see this. It has been overfitted all the points of a training set. Instead of this line, you can have these kind of a line which have been shown in a brown color. So instead of a narrow fitting or a complex fitting, you can just have a parabolic structure in order to make a differentiation between class A and class B. Instead of a complex line, you can have a parabola. So this is a solution for overfitting. Finally, I would like to say that people don't need 100% of accuracy, but practically lesser error committing algorithms are acceptable. So this is one of the best solutions to overcome underfitting or overfitting. So in the next video, we can just see the how to differentiate the linear data and the non-linear data. So that's it for the video guys. Remember to subscribe. Stay tuned to get tech related videos. If you find the video helpful to your friends, do share them. Give thumbs up for the video. Meet up in the next videos. Thank you for watching.